Who's on fire? You've got a bucket of water. Who's actively currently on fire?
This is the Sales Guerrilla Podcast. How do I get somebody from, hey, I like the fact that you have these cute puppies that you posted on Facebook, and I also see that we went to the same college and or maybe like the same baseball team. Would it make sense to get on a phone call? For me, that's such a weird, awkward transition. And if somebody hit me with it, I'm like, whoa, now all of a sudden I feel like you were trying to be my friend. And now all of a sudden you're trying to jump into bed with me. And I didn't see this coming.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So that's two pieces. One is ideal client avatar, right? So we've identified the human being. Now let's back up for a second and let's clarify. Let's make sure that that person is also in the marketplace looking for the thing that you do. They're already giving indicators out there. They're asking stuff in Facebook groups. They're posting stuff on LinkedIn. They're asking their friends for a referral. They're actively pursuing a solution that you can provide. Then we identify natural relatability, points of connection. Puppies, same school, they like the same band, they talk about the same kind of things, right? That's all ideal client avatar. Well, if we know the one, right, keep in mind we're leveraged marketers, we're actively trying to identify the perfect for us people. So it's an assumption. You're already starting with somebody who wants and needs the thing. Now you're identifying out of that big ass group of people who in that group of people you actually want to do business with. That's ideal client avatar. The second piece of this is CUP, current urgent problem. Out of those people that want it, need it, and are the right fit for you, who's on fire? You've got a bucket of water. Who's actively currently on fire? Well, they just posted something on social media. They just asked one of their buddies who knows you that sent you a message. They just asked a question. They reached out to you. Well, it's pretty easy when that's the case to say, hey, I didn't realize you were looking for that thing. That's something that I do. Do you want to talk about it? This is what I mean. All the magic comes before that question. You've got to identify that they are actively looking for that thing to say, we might not be a fit, but I'd be happy to spend 10 or 15 minutes with you and talk about why you think you need that thing. That's just one of a million ways to ask that question. But it only works and it only happens well and easy if we've already established a little foundational relationship. Built some presence, we've created some awareness, and we've established a little bit of authority around what it is that we do, which is the marketing piece of it. And then all we got to do is start the conversation. But the starting of the conversation should be so easy and so apparent because you've identified those things. They want it, they need it. They're actually on fire. There's somebody I would totally dig working with, and I'm willing to give a little bit of my time, which is Landon's highest value currency. I'm willing to give a little bit of my time to them to help them figure out their path. And it might not be with me.